So let's understand package building profile. So orders are placed on products which during the real process are packaged to create packages and pallets. So this entire package building is inserted into the overall planning process at the freight unit building step. It allows products to be combined into packages. And then these packages are later used in subsequent planning steps. So, as I mentioned, that it is basically getting done at the freight unit building step. So here you can see that in freight unit building rule of one of the freight units, this package building profile have been called up because of which the package building have happened, and we can see this entire thing. Okay, so to understand how this entire package building have been called upon and it have basically done this entire thing, at first we will go and we will check our product, because the quantity or the unit of measure gets defined at the product level. Okay, so we will log into GUI and we will check this product for the details. Plant for this particular product is 1712, sales organization is 1710, distributor channel is US. Okay, so here if you see that it is already defined that the base unit of measure is piece, and if we go further to the additional data in the unit of measure, it is mentioned that how basically the definition of this piece and further definition of carton and pallets have done here. So this product is of piece type, and 10 such pieces can get accommodated into a carton, and 50 such pieces can get accommodated into pallet, which simply means that one pallet can accommodate 5 cartons and one carton can accommodate 10 pieces. So this is how the definition is already set up at a product level. So this is the very first step when it comes to understanding package building profile, because at first the basic unit of measure is getting defined at the product level. This setting has to be there on the place and to be checked at first. So this is one thing. After that, if I go back, so this particular product of piece type is basically is getting packed in a carton. So to check that where this information is given, we will once again go and we will check. So we will go to the T code, which is SM30. And in that, because now here we can either check or we can define the product package type assignment. So we will go to SCMB/V-PPTA, product package type assignment. Once we go here, we can see that for this particular product, SHLP PROD01, the packaging material is this. And this packaging material is of carton type, which is mentioned here. And to add further, we can provide more details that what will be the height of the package, what will be the weight, and all such things can be provided here. Okay, so in product package type assignment, it is defined that this piece type of a product is getting packed in a carton, which is the packaging material. To add further, in system, this packaging material we are defining in the form of a product itself, which carries only basic information, not much. So let's go and let's check the details of this particular product, which is a packaging material in this case. Okay, so we will go and we will check this material. So we will check this product. It carries very basic information, so we don't need to select each and every detail. We will select only these four basic things. And the base unit of measure for this packaging material is carton. To go further, when we go to the additional data and on the units of measure, we can see that it is a carton type, and in one pallet, five such cartons can get accommodated. Okay, so here the details of this particular packaging material, we can go, we can check, and this is how we can define another packaging material as well. Okay, so this is where we have checked at a product level what all are the settings which are required for a package building to work and function properly. Now the next thing is, when we have seen that how basically these definitions are happening, okay, we will go and we will check that basically so now when we have checked settings at both the products level, now we need to understand that what exactly happening at this package building profile, which is helping to invoke these settings from the product level, okay? So to check that what exactly is happening in this particular package building profile, we will be going to the configuration, okay? In configuration, we will be going to transportation management. In transportation management, let's go to planning. And here we will go to package building. Define package building profile. This is the package building profile which have been called up in our freight unit. So let's open it up and let's check that what exactly is provided in here. So these are the details, and there are many such details which we can provide based on the requirement of your package building, like mixed layers, mixed packages, like if we want to combine different products in one particular pallet. So there are many different settings which we can provide, grouping preference, group same products together, products by customers, volume based or mixed package building. So there are many details, stars or layers, which depends on height and its width and those things. So there are many different, consider density first or weight first. So there are, these are the details which are provided at a package building profile, which helps to invoke the settings which are at the product level. And this is how, in combination, the entire package building works.